the ubiquitous cranes of China. As the joke goes, if Chinese developers have their way, this could become the national bird. And property speculation, a national sport. In reality, it's no laughing matter. A building frenzy, skyrocketing property prices, and more investors than there are occupants. The signs of a property bubble brewing in the world's second largest economy are there. How do loan sharks, interest rates, and mother-in-laws play a role in this bubble? China's housing bubble became a talking point as early as 2005, way before America's property market sneaked up on everyone and went bust spectacularly. We jet set to four Chinese cities for a ground report on what it means to be living in the world's largest property bubble.
在家里有时候心情不好的时候啊，有时候上街上一看郑州市变化这么大，高楼大厦的，环境也特别好，一回到家里一看就心里不舒服。中国好多老百姓那时候想买房子，但是房价一天天往上涨，涨得很快，就觉得自己买不起了，就觉得自己生活压力特别大。
房价都被有钱人炒起来了，根本就好像是把我们年轻人往这个北京外面赶了。
一年你赚的钱吧，一年赚几万块钱，还没有他房子涨得快。这样的话，如果你不买的话，就相当于这一年的工作又白干了。